So first of all, Brandon Krause, another day at the office. Jesse Martinez, what's the record right now?
2-0.
How many knockouts?
One knockout.
2-0 is one knockout. And when is your next fight?
It's this Saturday at in downtown LA at the Westin Bonaventure.
Brandon, what can we expect?
You can expect another great performance. You know, last time out, we definitely stole the show. And, you know, this guy, Magic Martinez, that's what he wants. He wants to give everybody a magical evening, their money's worth. You know, I've never met anybody that trains harder to make a fist. I never met anybody that's more dedicated. I never met anybody that sacrifices more than this guy. And you better believe it, man. He's gonna be our next superstar, you know, our next De La Hoya, our next Cotto, our next Canelo. This guy is coming up right now.
Jesse, what do you think of Cotto Canelo?
I kind of felt like it just showed that Canelo was a lot younger, a lot faster, a lot bigger. His punches showed more. And I don't know. I just think Cotto wasn't strong enough that night.
So you have, obviously Canelo won, right? Brandon, Canelo won?
Canelo won.
Cotto was on the radio today in Puerto Rico saying that he won. And
He thought he won?
He said he won the fight. He won 8 rounds. And it's...
You know, you can't treat a fight like a math problem. And I think if you were there ringside, you would see that all everything else being equal, Canelo's punches were bigger. So that's what separates him, you know? So if you have a pretty much even round and then you analyze, or you're a judge and you analyze that even round at the end, you go, okay, what separated these guys? All right, well, when this guy landed, there was more impact. There was more hurt on his punch. I'm going to give him the round.
I only gave Cotto 2 rounds, and I was being generous. I could only give him 1. Like the judge who gave it 119-109, and people criticized that. Max Kellerman said he agrees with that card. But okay, boxing.
I don't agree with that card, but what I just described is probably what happened, is that this judge looks at these pretty competitive rounds each time and goes, all right, you know, still Canelo is the one edging out every one of these competitive rounds, and at the end of 12 rounds, it looks lopsided.
Floyd Mayweather blamed Freddie Roach for the loss. He said Roach did not tell Cotto anything good in the corner. He didn't tell him go out and go for the knockout, kill or be killed, or... He said people give Freddie Roach all this credit, yet Manny Pacquiao loses to Marquez. Manny Pacquiao loses to Mayweather. Cotto loses to Canelo. And Freddie said he's betting both his houses on the fight.
Freddie's good at selling a fight. You know, Freddie got, you know, helped with this promotion. Canelo, you know, what a guaranteed $5 million plus, you know, whatever the heck else he has. 15, I'm sorry, $15 million.
For Cotto.
And probably Freddie, you know, who was a boxer himself, who suffers, you know, the effects of Parkinson's, maybe boxing related, thought, all right, you know what? I'm not gonna have my guy Cotto go out on a shield. He's gonna go out there. He's gonna box, and maybe we'll win a boxing match. And Canelo, for his part, was content to box with the boxer really all
and
night.
And he did good.
You know?
He slipped. He dipped. He landed uppercut. And you can see when he landed a big shot on Cotto, Cotto wanted nothing of it. He wasn't going to stick around. He got on his bicycle a little bit.
Yeah, sure. But that's part of the strategy to beat Canelo is use your legs, because you know that's his
okay.
foil.
Last question. Canelo, GGG.
You know, this is what I got to say is that Triple G has been fed lambs. And now all of a sudden he's going to have a genuine, you know, world-class guy in front of him. It'll be interesting to see. You know, can Golovkin be as dominating versus a world-class guy as he has been against the B-level players? Or did his handlers totally screw him over because he didn't get to develop in the way necessary to handle this a solid A fighter right in front of him.
Jesse, what do you think?
I think it'll be competitive, but I kind of feel like Triple G will beat Canelo using his size advantage, and he has strong power. He uses his jab good. I just see Triple G being a little bit too big for Canelo.
You know, I'm gonna tell you guys what's funny. People always criticize Canelo. Maybe it's jealousy. Maybe it's something else. First, they say his corner sucks. The guy won every fight except Mayweather, and you can't blame him because he was a kid and Mayweather beats everyone. Then they say his conditioning. Then they say this. His conditioning was great yesterday. He went all 12, wasn't breathing heavy.
Yeah, but he never got really pushed, you know, because Cotto was down the box, you know, and that favored Canelo, you know, looking lively in rounds 11 and 12.
Let me tell you what really happened. Cotto saw Holly Holm sitting ringside, and he did not want to become Ronda Rousey number two, so he did everything that he can do not to get knocked the F out. And he succeeded in that, so I give Cotto credit for not getting knocked out, but he did not win the fight.
And maybe, you know, maybe there was a little... Canelo is like one of these prideful, you know, Latinos, as is Cotto. Maybe it was a respect thing not to go out there and blow him out.
Well, he did say that Cotto was one of his favorite fighters growing up, so it's possible. He beat Cotto's brother. Now he beat Cotto. He did a pretty good job. I remember Larry Mosley used to come to this gym, and he fought Canelo, and he would tell me day in and day out how he won that fight.
I remember.
Did he win that fight?
No. Sorry, Larry.
But every fighter thinks he wins his fight.
Yeah, you know what? Because you're in there fighting, and you don't really... You don't, like, feel or process pain when it's crazy like that. It's hard to judge your own fight because of that.
Okay, so...
Because punches hit you, and you go, whatever. Like, it meant nothing to me, you know?
So if I sat down with Miguel Cotto and watched his fight with Canelo, will he still say that he won after he watches it?
Cotto's a pretty stubborn guy. I don't know.
I don't know. I think after he watches it, he'll agree.
I don't know what Miguel Cotto would think.
He said Miguel Cotto said today he doesn't need the WBC and the WBC doesn't need Miguel Cotto. Why does he talk in third person? What is he, LeBron James?
He is the LeBron James of boxing. Absolutely.
All right. There you have it. Miguel Cotto, the LeBron James of boxing. FuseNewsReport.com. I'm Melissa Quack reporting.